Shanti. We heard a beautiful song that the company of God is such a unique company. No human company can be compared with God's company. And this is the essence of Shrimad Bhagavad Gita also. Make God your companion, as Arjuna made him his companion. Because companions are such who guide us at every step, and they never wish ill of us. They are always our good wishers. When God becomes our companion, then we also are able to overcome whatever difficulties that come in our path, whatever situations that we go through. He is always there to lend his hand and take us across in a smooth manner. Shrimad Bhagavad Gita, the knowledge is so unique. Why? Because it is beyond what human beings are experiencing. It takes us beyond. It transcends our stage from a gross level to a higher level. Knowledge of Gita is incomparable in the way that it transcends us from a gross level to a higher level. And it is applicable for all human beings. Not only just for Hindus or for any particular sect or particular type of people, but for the entire world. And that is why we all know that the translation of Gita has been done in maximum languages of the world. No other book has received so much of translation as Srimad Bhagavad Gita, which means people from all the faiths, people from different backgrounds, wanted to know and understand the wisdom that is within Gita. No other religious text got so much of translations in so many languages. Therefore, we can say that Gita is such a book of wisdom where each and every human being finds an answer to the different types of problems that they are facing. It has pure spiritual knowledge, and its intrinsic beauty is that its knowledge applies to all the human beings and does not postulate any sectarian ideology or secular view. It is approachable from the sanctified realms of all religions and is glorified as the epitome of all spiritual teachings by the Supreme. If we just look at Shrimad Bhagavad Gita and its background, why is Shrimad Bhagavad Gita so special? We all know the story of how it came into the practical form. That Veda Vyasji once was sitting in his meditation and he went into a trance. And in the trance, he saw the divine visions of God and the knowledge that was related by God to Arjuna. So the first day when he came out of his trance, he wanted to sit down and write down whatever he saw. But trance is such a stage where people forget. They are not able to recollect as it is shown. So the first day, whatever he saw in his trance, he was not able to write it down. So the next day, he knew that the trance was not complete. The vision was not complete. So as he sat in trance in his meditation, he took something to write so that whatever he would see, he would note down. But it is said that the next day also, he became so engrossed in seeing the divine visions that he was not able to write as it is. So the third day, he requests God, "Oh God, you are giving me such valuable treasures, such powerful wisdom, but how can I pass it on to the human beings if I'm not able to write it down? So I need someone to write." So it is said that the third day, Ganeshji comes to write what he will be narrating during the trance period. But Ganeshji comes with a condition and he says that wherever you will stop, I will go away. Because I am a fast writer, so you should constantly go on narrating and non-stop I would go on writing. Vyasji agreed with this. So it is said that the third day, when he sat in his meditation and he went into the trance, whatever he was seeing, he started narrating. But the third day's vision was such, which had great spiritual significances, which was filled with some secrets. And in order to understand the significance and the secret, he had to take a pause. But in his subconscious mind, he was aware that if I take a pause, Ganeshji would go away. So I should not pause. So in this dilemma, what he did was, he narrated the scenes that he saw as it is and thought, once I get the matter, afterwards I can relate it with the significances. So he narrated all the scenes that he visualized as it is. But afterwards, when he sat down to clarify the significance behind those wisdom that he had narrated, he was unable to do it. Why? Because he had narrated the whole vision in Sanskrit. And Sanskrit is a powerful language where one word also has so many different meanings. And after the trance, he forgot the vision. So he was not able to recall from which angle or with which purpose he had given that word. So he left the Gita as it is, which was then interpreted by so many people who tried to understand Gita. And therefore, there are so many opinions about the wisdom of Gita. Some said that the war took place practically. Some say it is the war that is constantly going on in human minds. Some come out with a different meaning. Others would come out with a different meaning. And that is why we find one Gita has so many types of interpretations, as is the level of consciousness of each and every human being, as is the state of mind of each and every human being. Accordingly, they interpreted Gita. The original Gita, which was given by Vyasji, was quite small. It had 18 chapters, but was quite small, round about in between 400 to 500 shlokas. But in the process of interpretation, some great souls, they added to clarify those shlokas. And this is how we find that the Gita comes up to 700 shlokas in 18 chapters. The wisdom which is there in the Shrimad Bhagavad Gita is unique in the sense that it gives the salvation for all different levels. We all know that the state of mind Arjuna was having, the nervousness that he was going through, the depression that he came into, and he needed salvation for that. So there is salvation for the state of mind of souls in the present world. So at an individual level also, the wisdom of Gita is there to guide us. Then we find that the Mahabharat war and the message of Gita, which came into existence, was because there was a family problem. Pandavas and Kauravas were members of one family, the Kuru family. But there was a difference of opinion in the family. And in the difference of opinion, they started fighting. And the difference of opinion was due to wealth, kingdom,